going too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling is vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to burn, I was born for this.
Whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Better that you rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
Always hanging on to the visual. I wanna be invisible. Looking at my ears like I'm out of dumb. Everybody needs to be a part of them. Never be enough on the prodigal son. I was born to run.
My dad's in there cooking dinner, so let's see what he's cooking up, shall we? What are you cooking?
Nachos. Don't put it so close to the base. So nobody wants to see that.
That looks nice.
Alright, you reckon?
Yeah, it looks good. What type of nachos? Nachos?
What type is there? I didn't know there was different types.
There's fish tacos.
Oh, sorry. Did I say tacos? I meant nachos.
No, I meant to say nachos.
Nachos.
I'm a bit kooky.
Hmm? You're a bit kooky?
Yeah. Look, he's adding seasoning to it. And so here's cheese and our, what is it, sour cream, and our thick and chunky salsa and our nacho chips. What are you having for dinner?
More wine.
What are we having
honestly,
for dinner?
We're since having... we got here, I've been wined at almost 100% of the time.
We're having pasta alfredo with cheese and we're having beef sausages.
Cool.
Not very interesting, but it's okay.
Let's go see what the others are having. I think they've had their dinner, but still, let's see what they're having. What did you have for dinner?
Oh, I don't know. I forgot. No, I'm joking. I had rice, sausage, and veg. Yeah, wash it.
Sounds pretty plain.
Is your kettle boiling?
Does it sound like it's boiling?
Yeah.
I can't hear it whistling.
Well, there's water in it, that's what I mean. Okay, well, we had nachos. I didn't know that, so, yeah.
Well, a nice night there at Lake Jasper. Apart from the mosquitoes, they were pretty savage. Today I think we're just going to make our way to Pemberton, but we've got a few caches to pick off on the way. Cattleman's Hut. Gone past it so many times, always been on my bucket list, and never had the time to get there. But whatever happens, I should be there today.
Getting here, and we're still 250 metres from ground zero.
Yeah.
But that's all right, we're going to wipe this cattleman's hut off today if it kills us. What do you reckon, Mark?
Who's got a pen?
I've got all my kit in my bag.
Good.
Well, this looks like fun, 200 metres through the scrub to the cattleman's hut.
Walk in the park,
It's easier than walking through Spinifex, so I'll give you the drum. Oh, Greg, this has got to be one of your typical cases. But thanks for bringing us out here anyway, even though we haven't found it yet. Sorry? You got a visual on it? Or just GPS?
GPS, it's showing
it
90 degrees here.
Okay. We've got structure. Corrugated iron.
We do, we do.
We have the cattleman's hut. Wow. That's what's left of the cattleman's hut. Now we've got to scare all the tiger snakes and find the cache. Well, we have found the cache. Problem is there's a tree that's fallen on top of it and we can't get to it. So Mark's going to do a little bit of MacGyvering and we should be able to reef it out. Things we do for a cache, hey?
I put my hand on it, but it's wedged. Firmly wedged under that piece of tin.
We get a piece of tree and try and lever the tin up, do you think?
Yeah.
Looking good. Guess what we have?
Yay!
Hey,
I win!
Well done.
Cash zero, Subaru's odds one.
Look how good a condition it is. It hasn't been found for over 3 years.
Really?
Actually, it's coming up 4 years since it was last found.
2013, wasn't it?
2015. So April 2015. So almost 4 years. Fantastic, how good's that? Well, I know the CO and I owe him for some things that he's given me over the years. So thank you for that, Greg. And to keep some interest in your most magnificent cache, I think it's worthy of one of my signature PAF tags. So thanks again, Greg. It was great fun getting here. Now we're gonna try and bash through the scrub to get back to the car. Just 20 odd metres from the hut, you come across an old fence post. Obviously, part of the holding yard where you would hold some animals. Pretty cool. My goodness, what a nightmare.
Yay.
Getting back from that case. Getting there wasn't actually that bad. But we have veered so far off course on the way back. On the way back.
Don't know about anyone else.
I need a beer.
I wish I had one, but I don't. I'll have to have something else.
So right now we're at Goblins. I just lost the track. I would piece to give me that. Which
Goblins, yeah. Which is a walking place. So we're going to go for a little walk to do a geocache, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah. I've got Goblins Swamp, which is a bit of a change of plans. We got the place wrong. So we're at Goblins Swamp right now. So I'll come in and let you take a look at the place. It's really cool.
Ready?
Probably blew up one.
Look at that.
All swampy, there's water there. Look at all the trees.
Melaleuca Swamp.
Look at the way the trees are shaped. We came here for a geocache. But this is cool, isn't it, guys? Charlie,
How does the swamp look to you?
Oh, it looks awesome. It looks like a thing straight out of Harry Potter.
This is wacky. Oh, I should slip them. I'm wearing thongs while everybody else is wearing normal shoes. Maybe hold it a bit tighter.
Trust me, I've dealt with cameras before.
I never said you were.
We're not the best camera people, so deal with us. Hang on.
You are. Hang in there.
But yeah, this is pretty cool.
Yeah, it's photo time.
Isn't it?
Look at all the people trying to take photos.
After spending some time at Goblins, we started to make our way towards Pemberton, stopping in at Beetle Up Falls so the others could pick up a few caches and we could check the place out.
Sure. Duck poop.
Another book for white stuff in bird droppings. The white stuff is actually their wheat. It's a product of the kidneys.
Oh, okay. I'm glad you told me that. I like it so much.
I just found it interesting.
Hmm.
Maybe it's good enough for a seagull.
Well, after a nice night in Pemberton and dinner at the pub, we're hitting the road again for a few more geocaches. Unfortunately, back into the dust. Team Red Roo and Mr. Luna went south to find some caches, while the rest of us hung around the Dave Evans bicentennial tree for a bit of leisure climbing a tree, if you could call it leisure. Of course, the kids had to pick the highest tree to climb, 65 metres to the top of the David Evans tree.
Well, I'm up to the first platform. That was the easy bit. Kids have buggered off. They're going all the way. And this is what we've got to look forward to. The next part is a bloody long way up there. Goddamn bloody kids, look what they made me go on and do. Apart from hitting the head.
He just hit his head really hard.
We are at the top.
You.
That's a bloody long way up.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to go live on Instagram.
Yeah.
Pretty cool. Make sure when you get to the platform, no one's coming up the other way, okay? Yeah, okay, I'm just telling you. Stop wobbling the tree. It's wobbly up here.
You're having a good time? Yeah. You're looking a bit tired. Yeah. Hard work climbing that tree, wasn't it? Over there where all the click line is. Can pick off another couple of cases. We look like a bunch of Japanese tourists.
Hello, kangaroo. How are you? Good. Oh, that's a little baby
having fun, are we?
Oh yeah, heaps of fun. Windy
Windy Harbour. Is it windy?
No, I'm not.
This is all business, mate.
All
very
business.
Hard. Very difficult.
Well, best you drink up. Hard business.
So we made it, yay. I have a souvenir.
Beautiful.
Do you know how hard it is to drink down?
I reckon it would be hard to drink down.
I bet without even trying, you drink up.
I drink down. My cask of red is just about empty. That level's been going down.
I see.